going to present is based on minor losses. Minor losses are local energy losses caused by disruption in flow rate due to installation of apparatuses such as valves, vents, and other fittings. Minor losses are almost negligible as compared to frictional losses in case of long pipes, but in case of short pipes, they are of good proportion and hence cannot be neglected. Minor losses account the following types: losses of head due to sudden enlargement or sudden contraction, losses of head at entrance of pipe, losses of head due to bend in pipe, and losses of head due to obstruction and fittings in pipe. Now we will be going to discuss about losses due to sudden contraction. In this case, the diameter of the pipe is reduced suddenly due to contraction, and due to which a turbulence in the flow is created, which leads to the formation of vena contracta, which is a region in a pipe where the diameter of the flow rate is minimum and hence velocity is maximum. And due to the following reason, minor losses due to sudden contraction occurs, which can be calculated with the formula HL equals to K V square by 2G, where HL equals to a loss in head, K equals to resistance coefficient, V equals to velocity of the liquid in the region of contraction, and V equals to acceleration due to gravity. Now, in case of sudden enlargement, turbulent eddies are formed at the corner of enlargement of the pipe section, which you can see in the image as well. The formation of eddies causes loss of energy in the form of soundings, which can be calculated with the help of formula HL equals to V1 square minus V2 square by 2G, where HL equals to head loss, V1 equals to velocity in the region of lesser diameter, V2 equals to velocity in the region of greater diameter, and G equals to acceleration due to gravity. Now Gopal would explain you the experiment further.
Hello everyone. Now I am going to discuss loss of the head due to bend in pipe. When there is any bend in pipe, the velocity of the flow changes, due to which the separation of the flow from boundary takes place. There is formation of eddies also, which results in loss of energy. This loss of head occurs as HF is equal KV square by 2G. HF is head loss due to bend, V velocity of the flow, K is coefficient of bend. Next, loss of the head at the exit of the pipe. This loss of the head due to the velocity of the liquid being dissipated at the outlet of the pipe in the form of a free jet. The loss of the head expressed as H is equals to V square by 2G. V is the velocity at the outlet of the pipe. H is head loss. Now I will discuss apparatus used in this experiment. YouTube manometer measure the differential pressure. Stopwatch measures the time taken for the rise of 10 cm in collecting tank. And GI pipes having contraction for different diameter range. Collecting tank to collect the water. Now I will discuss the procedure part. Note down the diameter and length of the pipe. Note down the area of collecting tank. Keep the pressure tapping of the pipe open. For another pipe, it should close. Adjust the flow rate to its maximum value. Record the discharge flowing with water level in left limb and right limb of the manometer tube. Reduce the flow rate by means of flow control valve. Record the reading in manometer. Now further, Gitika will explain the video of this experiment.
This is experiment to calculate minor losses in pipe fittings. In this experiment, we will calculate loss due to sudden contraction, sudden expansion, and sudden bend. We will take three readings for sudden contraction, 3 readings for sudden expansion and 3 readings for sudden bend. This is a valve for the pipe. Along the pipe, this valve is open, and perpendicular to the pipe, this valve is closed. We'll keep this valve open. This is the main gate valve. This valve should be open. This is manometer. These are manometer valves. This is collecting tank valve. Now we are going to start the experiment by pressing the start button.
स्विच ऑफ है लैपटॉप बड़ी मुश्किल से सर से बोल के बोला पहले मेरा ले लो काम.
फर्स्ट वी विल नोट द रीडिंग्स फॉर सडन कॉन्ट्रैक्शन. सो वी विल ओपन दीज वॉल्स. बिफोर टेकिंग दीज मैनोमीटर रीडिंग्स वी हैव टू ओपन मैनोमीटर वॉल्स टू रिमूव एयर बबल्स. Air bubbles must be removed to take accurate readings. After some time, we will close these valves. After closing these valves, we will take manometer readings. Now we will note the time taken for 10 cm rise of water. For this we have to close collecting tank valve. We'll start the stopwatch and note the time taken for 10 cm rise of water. Similarly, we will take other two readings by changing the flow rates. And we'll carry the same experiment for sudden expansion and bend. Now further calculations will be explained by Arsh.
Sorry, sir. Good afternoon, everyone. Now I will be discussing the observation table. The first column tells manometer readings in the two cases of sudden expansion and sudden contraction. Next column records the time of these two cases for 10 cc rise of water level in collecting tank. The last column indicates the diameter of pipes during sudden contraction and sudden expansion of flow. Now I will be discussing the formula used. The V1 column is the initial velocity, which is volumetric flow rate Q by cross sectional area A1. The V2 column indicates the final velocity, which is flow rate Q upon cross sectional area A2. The KL is the resistance coefficient value during sudden expansion and sudden contraction. Now head loss of flow is KL into V1 square minus V2 square by 2G. Now moving to precautions. Note down the mean value carefully. Avoid parallax error due to color of fluid while noting manometric reading. Keep some level of fluid in inlet and outlet tank and maintain a constant discharge in each reading. That was all about today's presentation.